Hey guys, welcome to the tool review, and today we are going to review the Grand Harvest 11 tool multi-tool. I got this from Amazon. I'll put the link below in the description. So this, as said by Amazon, this is a multi-tool which has 11 features, and so let's see what all it has. So starting with we have the big blade. There is a locking mechanism onto it, and it's called a slip joint mechanism. You can see it snaps. There's a slip joint mechanism. There's the main blade, says stainless. Blade is okay, pretty sharp, not that much. Okay, second, what we have here, okay, it's the saw. The saw is very sharp. It has teeth which are aligned different way. It has crisscross set of teeth, so yeah, can be used for some cutting. I have a bag here. Well, it's not a clean cut, but yeah, I mean, if you want to break something down, can be used for that. Then the next is this. It's kind of a small, honestly, I really don't know what this is for, because it's blunt, does not have any sharp edges. I'm just rubbing my hand over it, nothing is happening. I seriously don't know what this is for. What should I call it? Should I call it the mini saw? Should I call it the useless saw? I don't know, whatever. Then the scissors, spring loaded scissors. Don't have the usual spring, you have the metallic leaf spring over here. Feels nice, tactile. Let's try cut something. Okay, not bad. Cuts something thin. Let's try to cut something thick. By the way, this is a bubble wrap pack I received something today in. Okay, still cuts. Not that cleanly, but yes, it does cut. You have to be pretty much precise, but okay, not bad. Next is this bottle opener come flathead screwdriver. Nice addition. Then we have this one. This is a bottle opener come can opener, but the edge over here of the can opener is pretty blunt. I don't know how nicely it's going to open the cans. On the back side, corkscrew, thin corkscrew. There is a lot of play, considerable amount of play in the tools. I don't like that. Then, okay. Looks like a punch with a hole, maybe to get a thread or something like that through different surfaces. Then okay, starting from this side, we have a nice Phillips head. Nice, you can have that nice torquing action if you are torquing something up. Nice Phillips head. Then ow, what is this? Looks like a reamer punch. I don't know, tools are pretty blunt. Then this, you just put it down. These tools are pretty hard to open and close at the same time. I'm just trying to be safe. Okay, yeah, this is a nail file, yeah, with a pointy edge. You can get some filing done. Okay, so, and this is metallic, nice scaling, feels good in the hand, but okay, pros and cons. Pro, cheap, really cheap, to less than 200 rupees. Cons, really cheap. The steel is not that good, the tools have a lot of play. I really doubt the durability of this knife. But then for 200 bucks, Okay, what else can you ask for? Nice sharpness. This, if anyone could explain me what this thing is for, that I would be really delighted. You can leave your comments down below. I'm looking forward to your answers on what this thing really is. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll put the link below in the description. And I know it'll be unfair to this knife, but whoa, there's some flex in the body. There is some flex in the body. And I really don't like that. So okay, not an issue. I'll do one thing, I'll try and compare this with one of my old and trusted Victorinox. Both have probably the same height. Victorinox is a bit thinner, it has less tools. So okay, fine, that will be a video for another day. Let me see how I go across with this one.